Hello dear student, welcome back to e-content section of All India Sri Shivaji Memorial Society's Institute of Information Technology, Pune. I am Vikram Deshmukh, Assistant Professor at Engineering Sciences Department, AISSMS, IIT, Pune. So today we are going to discuss about introduction to engineering mechanics. So before going into details of engineering mechanics, we should learn some important concept so we should able to differentiate between these different concept. So first concept is, what is science? So science may be defined as growth of ideas through observation and experiment. So it is a growth of ideas through observation and experiment. So now, what is difference between, what is a basic question we should able to differentiate, is difference between science and engineering. Science is the knowledge that come from observing fact about the universe carefully, carrying out experiment and making statement that are always true in particular condition. Whereas engineering is the application of mathematics and science to design and manufacture atoms that benefits humanity. That means it is the solution to real life problem. So engineering or engineers have directly their relation with society and it benefits humanity. So basically it is application of science. Now, what is applied science? It is a branch of science which coordinates the research work for practical utility and service of mankind, is known as applied science. So you can see the image showing difference between pure science and applied science. So basically applied science is the exact science of applying knowledge, whereas pure science is also known as basic science, is the exact science of development of the development of scientific theories. Now come to the point, classification of mechanics. So mechanics broadly classified into three main categories, that is mechanics of deformable bodies, it is also called as the strength of material, then important one that is we are going to learn in this course are mechanics of rigid bodies, it is also called as engineering mechanics, and third category is mechanics of fluid. Again, mechanics of deformable body are again classified into three types: strength of material, theory of elasticity, theory of plasticity. Whereas mechanics of rigid body, that is engineering mechanics, is classified into two main categories: statics and dynamics. Again, dynamics is subdivided into two types: kinematics and kinetics. Whereas mechanics of fluid has three categories, like ideal fluid, viscous fluid and compressible fluid. So now, what is mechanics? So mechanics is the branch of science which deals with study of forces and their effect on bodies in motion or rest. So let us understand the meaning with simple example. Let us say you want to design a machine or structure. If we are a mechanical engineer, mostly we design machines, and if we are civil engineers, mostly we will design structure. For the structure design of a building, we need to design each and every component of building, and it must be safe. It means each and every parts of this building must be designed safely. So let us assume that we are designing a beam of building. What we are going to do is we are going to analyze this beam. So we have to isolate this beam from all other members. Okay, all other members. This beam is connected to column and all other members of building, and these all other members are also applying force on this building. So now what will happen? This beam, we need to first understand what are the different forces acting on this beam and what are the effect of these forces on this beam. The first thing we need to do in order to analyze this beam, the beam is supporting the roof, so there will be forces coming from top, and it also supported by the column below it. So some reaction forces, say R1 and R2, also acting at supports from the bottom of beam. So once you understand this force, you can analyze its effect and these forces on the beam. So you can now clear with the definition. It is a science which deals with study of forces and their effect on body which is in motion or at rest. Now, this is a very basic question. You need to understand the difference between mechanics of rigid body, that is engineering mechanics, and mechanics of deformable bodies, that is strength of material. So as shown in from the figure, it is clear that there are two types of effect on beam due to different forces acting on beam. We can divide the effect into two categories. One is external effect and internal effect. What do we mean by external effect? If I am applying force on this body, and absorbing this body from outside, if it is externally supported sufficiently, it will be at rest. But if you have not provided enough support, then what is going to happen? Then this body is going to start to move in the direction of force, and if it is moving, then there will be some displacement, some velocity, and some acceleration. So study of this external effect due to application of force are called as engineering mechanics. That means engineering mechanics deals with the external effect of forces, whereas strength of material, there can be internal effects. So let's say this beam, this body, I am applying a force, it's supported, it is not going to move. What will happen? It will be at rest, it will be in equilibrium. And if you study internal forces due to application of external force, yep, some stresses and strains are going to introduced in the body due to external forces comes under the category of strength of material. That means the subject engineering mechanics and strength of material are studying same type of body. The situation will also same. External force applied will be same. The only difference will be that in engineering mechanics we will observing the body from outside, whereas we are interesting in in engineering mechanics we are interesting in finding displacement, velocity, acceleration due to external force. Whereas in strength of material, that is mechanics of deformable bobbin, we are interested to find out internal effect of the force due to application of external force. Now, engineering mechanics again divided into two subcategories, that is statics and dynamics. So what is statics? It is a branch of mechanics, it may be applied mechanics or engineering mechanics, which deals with action of forces on bodies at rest. That means statics is the branch of mechanics which deals with the study of forces on bodies at rest. So here you can, in image you can see the boy pushing the sofa is the example of statics. Whereas the dynamics is the branch of mechanics which deals with action of forces acting on a body in motion. In image you can see the car is moving with a velocity V and acceleration A due to application of force. So again dynamics is divided into two categories. Dynamics is divided into two categories, that is kinematics and kinetics. So what is kinematics? Kinematics is a branch of dynamics which deals with study of behavioral body under the action of external force without considering the causes of motion. Whereas in kinematics is the branch of dynamics which deals with study of behavior of body under the action of applied force with considering effect of with considering the forces causing the motion to body. So let us summarize what we have learned in today's video lecture. We have studied introduction to mechanics, classification to mechanics. Here are some references for further study of engineering mechanics. You can take a screenshot of it. You can also access online resources of AISSMS Institute of Information Technology by visiting following link. You can also do further study or further reading by visiting Swayam portal or INI Pune, Savitribai Phule Pune University online portal. Thank you all. Have a nice day. Happy learning. Let's learning continue. Thank you once again.